Hello, today we are going to talk about how to write up the literature review. In this section, I introduce to you the way to make a very good literature review for international publications or research projects or for your BA master thesis or PhD thesis. That's the way you present literature in the research. First, I give you some background questions so that you can read and you can discuss together, and after that you can have the knowledge and you can learn this lesson easier. Okay, can you have a look at the question for discussion? Question number one: when you have an intended topic for your research, what kinds of materials should you review and why? So far you think about the topics for your research already. That the previous sections that we conduct the introductions, we write the introductions, we also review. So now today, think about what kind of materials should you review. In your opinion, what is the purpose of the review of the related literature? Why do you need to review? Many students or BA master students, even PhD students, they don't like to write the literature review because it's not easy and takes a lot of time to read, to review, to write summaries, and then need critical thinking to critically discuss and give some argument, give some critics on the previous research study. So that's not easy, right? So think about why and what is the purpose of this section. The third question is, what's going on if you write a research paper without a review of related literature? So actually, when I read some research paper, I don't see there's a place for literature review. Here we think about writing the literature review in some research paper doesn't mean that they don't have the title of literature review, but actually they also review previous studies, but they conducted in one section of the introduction, but they review already. But in case that the paper did not have a literature review, so what do you think of it? The fourth question is, in your point of view, what is the most important thing in the review? How to write a good literature review? So that is just the lesson we learned today, how to write a good literature review. But think about what is the most important things in the review, right? Okay, and then you can discuss. The last question is that in doing research, should we write up the introduction first or the literature review first? And why? The previous sections about writing the introduction, we conduct writing the introduction first. But for this section, we said, should we write the literature review first or the introduction first, even though the introduction comes before the literature review? So in the research, there might be something different, okay? So can you have 5 minutes, discuss with your partners, and then come back, tell me your answers. Or you can leave the answers in the chat, okay? I can read the chats there. So you have discussed 5 questions that you have an intended topic for your research, what materials should you review? Most of you think about the books. The books is good, but mostly the book is out of date, right? So it might be published long ago, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, or 5 years ago. But research paper about our topic is always published continuously, every day, every year. So if you review both books and research papers, it is good. As previous sections, I told you about writing the references. So in terms of getting the research paper today, we are happy that we have a lot of open access journal, like International Journal of Visual and Education, or Asia Call Online Journals, or many other good journals that we can use for our research, right, to write this section. So at least if you use the research article to write the review, that is best, right? But if you write, you review in the book, that is okay. But don't forget the research paper, because in this section, it will tell the reader about the trends of the research. What's the trends of the research that most of researchers, previous researchers have done? So about this issue, then you can give good framework or picture for your own study. The second question, what is the purpose of the review of related literature? Why do we need to review? The purpose is just kind of its name, right? We review literature first to show people some frameworks about the topics or some theoretical concepts people have conducted already, that we have the hypothesis we discussed earlier, and then we also review the previous studies for the readers, for people to know that this topic is not just the way we do the research alone. We have the old background of research. We have the trends of research, and we also review the previous research to tell the readers that some people use some kind of research methodologies or some findings, the same findings, mixed findings, or opposite findings, or some kind of research designs. If they are good or not, then we provide a good research gap so that we take it as a rationale for our own study, why we take our own studies, and why we have those kinds of research questions that we have discussed earlier. If for the third question, in case that a research paper writing conducted without literature review, I don't think it is a good research paper, because it is a kind of just personal opinions or personal experience shared to other people. It doesn't have good science knowledge, background of science. So that paper cannot, even though they have the findings, the good results, but it cannot contribute to the body of knowledge, because the purpose of research is to go with the literature, find the research gap somewhere in the literature, so that it can bring the findings, the result, to fill in the gap in the literature, to build up good research literature. What is the most important thing in the literature review, and how to write a good review? So this question, we will go to this section, but the most important thing is that we can review previous research, and we can get some research gaps, the gaps that make our study seems important, and then we provide the framework for our study. That's the most important part in our literature review. And how to write good literature review, I will instruct you in this section. The fifth question. In doing research, should we write the introduction first or literature review first, and why? Mostly we write the introduction first, but in case if you review with prop reading, you write the literature review first. And then when you write the literature review, you will have a general knowledge, a general picture about the topics that you are going to do. So in this situation, when you write the introduction, you will have better views, better connections between the introductions and literature review. Because some people, when they write the introductions, and after that, when they review and they found out researchers have different aspects of results, findings, gaps, and then it might not connect between the literature and introduction. Okay, so in case if you write the introduction first and then the literature, what I strongly suggest is that if you do that, and then when you finish the literature review, you come back to your introduction to adjust, to rewrite, to paraphrase, to link, to put the introduction with the literature review like in logical order or like a chronological order, so that people can read like a story that leads to your research study. Okay, so now I invite you to watch a video clip from Jessica. She gave you very interesting way to write a literature review, the way that you should find the materials from the libraries, from the books, or from Google Scholars. Okay, so have a look.
Writing the literature review might be easier than you think. It's only a critical recap of what has already been researched on a topic, so no need to panic. In this video, you'll learn how to write a literature review in 5 simple steps. Hi, I'm Jessica from Scribbr, here to help you achieve your academic goals. We also zoomed in on all of the steps outlined in this video in separate videos. Check out the playlist here. Now let's get ready to start writing. Step 1. Search for relevant literature on your topic. In this context, literature just means any academic sources like books or journal articles about your topic. First, you need to search in the right scholarly database, so something like Google Scholar, PubMed, or Science Direct. Search your keywords with Boolean operators like these to help you filter and refine the search results. Check out this video to find out how to use them. Step 2. Evaluate and select sources. Unless your topic is super niche, you probably can't read everything that's been written on the topic. Once you've got the sources from step 1, read the abstract to scan whether an article is relevant or not. Also scan the bibliography to find other relevant sources. You should also pay attention to the citation count on Google Scholar. If the count is high, the source is probably important and you should include it. Step 3. Identify themes, debates, and gaps. As you read, take notes and pay attention to the connections between different sources. This way, you can organize your literature review's arguments and structure a lot easier. Here are some things to look for: trends and patterns in theories, methods, or results. Themes, debates or contradictions, influential studies, and gaps. Step 4. Outline your literature review structure. You can go about your literature review structure in a few ways. It all depends on what you found in the literature and what you want to emphasize. Here are 4 common approaches to structure the literature review. Chronological, that means from older to more recent publications. Thematic, so organized around several key themes. For methodological, you can compare the different research methods being used across studies. As for theoretical, you use it to discuss opposing theories or models. More details in this video. Check it out. And finally, get writing. Make sure your literature review has an introduction, a main body that summarizes and synthesizes the sources, and a conclusion, just like other academic texts. Now let's get your literature review started. To learn more about literature review, click this playlist. I'll see you there.
You have just watched a share from Jessica, and she gave you at least 4 steps you should do when you write the literature review. Like, first you search for relevant literature like search on Google Scholar, use the references from the papers, and then you can find more, right? The second step that you need to evaluate the resources to see if it is relevant to you. What does it mean by relevant? That it's relevant to your topics, right? To your research questions, what areas, what variable you investigate. So you need to see that one, and you also need to see what paper is acceptable, what paper is not acceptable, because today there are so many research or so many papers, so many materials published online. We are not sure which one until we need to read carefully and to assess the material. Step three, you need to identify the themes in the research or the debates. You debate, you argue, you critical read, and then you present the research gaps for your own study. And the third step, you need to outline your research. You need to outline what kind of outline. So she said that the most easy way, the easiest way you do is you use the chronological order or time order of research. But in this situation, I don't like it a lot, because if we just present the literature in time order, it doesn't make sense. We cannot argue for our own research. You just use it in case that you talk about the trends of research in times, right? But mostly, this is not very effective. The second is better, that you use the theme, thematic, that the theme of the research, mostly what kind of themes based on your research questions you review. And then even though in the literature there are different kind of research or different papers, then you organize them into each category to put them into the themes, right? So it is that I like this way most. The third is the methodology, that some people use some kind of method, research design. Some people just use a survey, something like that. We put them into order of the methodologies, right? And the last is about the theoretical, about some people follow some theories to apply into their research. But if it is effective or not to argue for their study. So the way you structure your literature review is not the thing that you take it easy or difficult or something, but it is the purpose of your study. What you want to argue for is very important. So you pick up one way, right? So in writing a research paper, the researcher needs to review mostly every section of the research to see to what extent which previous researchers or authors have done, to see the scholar's point of view about each issue. Like everywhere when you write, you need to review, like introduction, you have to review the literature review, you have to review research method, you have to review, even though when you do your findings, your results, you also need to review, right? But in this section, at least there are two sections that you need to review. The first one is about the theoretical literature. So when you do research about something, you need to review based on what theory that the people have conducted, or based on what theories that the topics you use and other people, they also provide some theories already, and then you might put some kind of theoretical framework for your study. The second section of this is that you review the previous research studies that I mentioned. I pay more attention to it, because you need to tell the people this topic is conducted already by previous studies, but what people have done, the findings they have, the results they have, and is there any research gap that you do this research to fill in the research gap, that is important. The first section about the theoretical literature. So In the journal article, the review of previous research study is more focused because it tells the reader the most recent trends in research in the investigated field. The review of theoretical literature is more appropriate of the writing of the introduction. So when you write for the international publications, then you use the theoretical literature you conduct for the introduction. That's why I told you that when you write the literature, you also need to review books or course books and other related materials are used to write up this section to provide general background of the investigated issues to the reader about your own topics. And the second section of the literature review is the review of we still have some section like a theory is a series of concepts organized into assumptions and generalizations that lead to hypotheses about the phenomenon, according to Clapton and China. Keep in mind that the theories you review should relate to your research problem and provide a basis for the empirical review that follows. Empirical review, like the review of previous studies. As I discussed earlier in the section of broad reading, writing references, doing research requires broad reading activities. You need broad reading not only for selecting appropriate topic for your research study, but you also do it for your related literature review about your topic areas, right? A literature review is a section, a research report that reviews a major research studies about the selected topic in order to give the reader a broad picture of what has been done in previous studies. It links your research with the prior research. So in this review of related literature or previous research studies, in this section, like you just write summary of the previous research, their methods, their data collection, their settings, their sample, their findings, and then you can give up the provide the research gap for your study. So this section is very important. In other words, the literature review briefly summarizes the previous research studies based on each category of your review of research question. So mostly you have two research questions, and then at least you have two sections of literature review about what you are going to investigate and what other researchers have been conducted. In order to write effective literature review, Markey and Gass advise you to keep in mind these things. First, you need to structure your literature review around your relevant issues of study. Do not review everything, right? Just review what closely relate to your study, to your topic. Second, writing empirical literature is not just listing series of previous studies without any arguments. So if you just list the first research paper, second research paper, third research paper, you don't connect them, you don't provide any arguments, you don't write any things that argue or tell the purpose why you review this section. So people don't understand, right? One time I sit in the thesis committees, and then when I ask the student, master student, about, because he had a lot of previous research review, I think that's good, but too many, and some reviews are not very related to the topic, some are not very support for the study. And then I asked him some question, can we remove this review? He said yes. And the other, can we remove that one? He think and he said, no, teacher. I said, why not? And he said, because this research very closely to my studies, and then based on this research, I conduct my own research to create the new methods or find the new things. As wow, wonderful. So read the literature review again. Each section, each paper, when you review, you need a purpose. Why you review this paper for your own study? That's important. So as you review relevant literature, you need critical discussion of it. Think about these questions. How do those studies relate to your own topics? What problems do they have in their studies? Like some scope that they cannot cover everything, right? The limitations of their study. What areas of research need to be further developed? Their research methodology, their research design, their data collection papers. Some research, they have good findings, but when you look at the data they analyze, they collected to analyze, you don't feel enough or not reliable enough or not persuasive, but not convincing you, then you need to argue, and then you do it for your own research to see if you have the same result or different results. Okay? What areas of research need to be further developed? After clarifying all these issues, you will come up with your own reasons for conducting your current research. Okay? So these questions are very important when you write this section. Finally, based on those problems from previous research studies, with all arguments or critical discussions related to your relevant issues, you should draw some conclusion to your study. That is the research gap, right? So the research gap is very important in this section. Later, I will tell you how to write the research gap. So when you write the literature review, you should, when you read like one paper, 10 pages, 20 pages, sometimes 30 pages. So what should you review? What should you write? Because when you write your study, you don't need to write a lot, okay? And you need a very focused structure. So here I give you the structures of writing the write a summary of the previous research study. So this is I have done do a lot of review, and then I find out this is good formula. I say the formula for you to write the literature review when you read a paper. Number one, you I call like we have three sections of reviewing the paper. Number one is the introduction. So in the introduction, I think in one paragraph, but I divide it into three sections. Like the introduction, you need to include the authors, the years of publications, and the purpose of the study, right? And then in the methods, you need to include the sections, the settings, the context, the research context, the samples, the data collections, methods, something like that. And the last section, you need to include the results of that research, the finding. And then you provide the research gap for the paper that you review. Okay, so this is important for you, and this is very good formula for you, because when you read, you take one paper for 20 pages, you don't need to read everything. Just find the important section to read. Okay, so this is very good formula. You should focus on this. Now I need you to work together and work with your group and tell your partner your topic that you have conducted, some research articles that you have reviewed or read, and then tell them like in what way the researchers review. I just give you the formula, but that formula might be for your BA thesis or master thesis or PhD thesis. But in the, when you read the international research paper, they might write in different way because they write shorter. So it's shorter what they include when they review, okay? So I give you 5 minutes, and then can you talk about it? You can use the paper that I, the sample research, or that I upload on the e-learning website, or you can use the research paper that I provided to you for your presentation, and then you can tell your partner, okay? 5 minutes.